Debbie Birch, and I'm with the Queen Anne's County Office of Tourism, and I'm here today to talk about some upcoming events, but the organization that the events are going to benefit. It's Compass Regional Hospice. They had a name change recently, located in Centerville, and I have Linda and Kenda here to tell us a little bit about hospice, who they serve, the area and that type of thing, and then the events that are coming up, because they're different events. They're, you know, not your usual fundraiser. So welcome, ladies.
Thanks, Debbie.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about the hospice, and, you know, now that the name change, again, like I said, people might not realize that it's the same one that's Queen Anne's County Hospice. So tell us about that.
Sure. Well, we appreciate being here today and talking about what used to be Hospice of Queen Anne's.
Right.
It's now Compass Regional Hospice, and we changed our name last year because in addition to providing hospice care for people in Queen Anne's County, we also now provide care for people in Kent County and Caroline County.
Oh, wow.
So, and we chose the name hospice because it signified that we as a hospice provider were setting off in a new direction.
Okay.
But we help our families. Our hospice families do the same thing. When someone gets a diagnosis of a life-limiting illness, they often don't know which way to turn.
Right.
And so the symbol of the compass replaced our old lighthouse, which was also a navigational tool for the same reason.
I see a theme going on there.
There you go. And so the compass was about helping patients and families find their way. And it also signifies that each of us who work at hospice has a moral compass that leads us to do the right thing for the right person at the right time in the right place.
Nicely said.
Thank you. And we're real proud of our new name. And I know for some people it's going to take a little bit of getting used to. So it's the same high quality hospice care. It expanded into three counties, Queen Anne still, Caroline, and Kent.
And for people who don't know where you're located, mm-hmm. you're in Centerville off of 213.
That's right.
You turn next to where the Food Lion Shopping Center is on mm-hmm. Corsable Drive. It's that big brick house. It looks mm-hmm. like a giant house sitting behind mm-hmm. the horse pasture.
Exactly.
That you see on 213. And people might not. I know for a while, mm-hmm. I didn't know what that was many years ago. I didn't know what that was. And I was like, oh, it's beautiful. It's a nice setting.
Yeah.
So,
and we're lucky to have such a pastoral setting that's very quiet mm-hmm. and welcoming, but so convenient
right
off of 213. And what we have there are two things. We have our administrative offices. We also have a 6-bed residential hospice center there. So we're licensed to provide what's called residential hospice care, but we also are licensed to provide general inpatient care, which is a step down from hospital care for a short period of time when people are receiving care at home, but maybe have symptoms that can't quite be managed at home, pain, nausea, and they come to our center to get kind of a boost in their medical treatment, and then they usually go home.
Okay, so you guys, you do fundraisers throughout the year, and I know you have two coming up pretty soon, and the first one is I'm excited about because I'll be helping with this one. It's going to be your first ever car show.
Yes.
And it's April 18th. So, Kenda, tell us a little bit about the car show.
The car show is April 18th, as you said, from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at 152 Comet Drive, which is right again on the way to hospice. And besides cars that can register that morning and all the cars there will be a lot of different vendors, food vendors, and a fun activity and a fun day for everybody to come out and enjoy themselves. There is no admission price to walk around to see the cars, so we encourage everyone to come out.
Wonderful. And the any proceeds that are made from car registration and all will go to hospice and benefit hospice.
It benefits Compass Regional Hospice, and just so everyone knows, at Compass Regional Hospice, we were every $100 of hospice care. We rely on 30 to come from fundraising dollars. And it also benefits our Hope and Healing Center, which is our grief support. That is all fundraising dollars that we count on for that program.
Okay, and then in May, you have your golf tournament, which you have every year.
Yes. Monday, May 18th at Prospect Bay and Country Club, we will have our golf tournament. We have individual golfers, team golfers. We also have a 9-hole and an 18-hole tournament. So that will registration starting at 11 a.m. and shotgun start at 1 p.m.
Okay. Yeah, because when I think golf tournament, I'm thinking you got to play a whole 18 holes. And sometimes that can get long if you're not an avid golfer.
No, we started the nine hole a couple years ago. It's really been beneficial and people enjoy it. So, and it brings out a whole bunch of different group of people that can't do the 18 hole.
Okay. Well, wonderful. So the first event coming up is the car show on April 18th and then the golf tournament is May 18th. You got an 18 thing going on there. It just hit me. I was like, they're both 18. I'm going to have you come back in another month or so because you have another event coming up in June, is it?
Sunday, June 14th. It's a farm to table dinner. It's going to be at Possum Point in Centerville. That'll benefit our Compass Kids program. The meal will include all local produce and seafood, and there'll be a silent auction.
Oh, wonderful. Okay, well, I'm going to have you come back to talk more about that and about your Camp New Dawn and some of the other activities that you all have going on. So we have your contact information on the board there. So if anybody has questions about the car show or the golf tournament, they can give you a call, or if they even want to find out about your what you guys do.
Absolutely.
So it's Compass Regional Hospice, and not Queen Anne's Hospice anymore. It's the same place.
Right.
I thank you both for coming in.
Thank you, Abby.